Namaskar, my name is Gaurish Borkar. Today, in this particular series, we are going to learn about the fifth stanza of first chapter of Brihat Jataka. The chapter's name is Rashi Prabhedadhyay. This is one of the most important stanzas in my studies of Jyotish, and that's because it explains one of the pillars of Jyotish. This is my own research. So I'm going to explain how I reached to that particular analysis and how the modern science helped me in my learning of this particular stanza in this video. So let's start. So the stanza is Matsyau ghati nru mithunam sagadam savinam Chapi naroshva jaghano makaro mrugasya Tauli sasasya dahana plavagacha kanya Shesha swanama sadrusha swacharascha sarve. This is the stanza. This stanza is in Vasanta Tilaka meter. This Vasanta Tilaka meter is actually a feminine meter because it is not Vasanta Tilakam. It says Vasanta Tilaka. Okay. And that is why as we go forward, as we go through the content, we will learn what exactly it means and what it indicates. So first let's look at the meaning of this stanza. So what does it say? It says two fishes, Pisces, a male with a pot, that's Aquarius, a couple with mace and Veena in their hands, that's Gemini, a man with a bow and a horse below hips, that's Sagittarius, a crocodile with the face of a deer, that's Capricorn, a person with a balance in hand, that's Libra, a girl sailing in a boat with a crop in one hand and fire in another hand, that's Virgo, and the remaining signs, Mesh, Vrishabh, Karka, Simha and Vrishchik, are signified by their names. So which are these? Ram, Bull, Crab, Lion, Scorpio respectively. This also indicates their habitat. This is what the stanza says. If you look at these symbols of signs, you would realize that they are much more than whatever we see in pictures. They are very detailed. Now we all shall wonder why these symbols are so detailed and what do they mean. I know many people ask this question and they challenge astrology by saying on what basis these symbols were designed, how come these symbols indicate the nature of the person and so on so forth. I'm going to answer most of these questions in today's video. So I want you all to wait till the end to get the answers of all these questions. So let's look at the padas. The padas are matsyav. Matsyav means two fishes. Ghati. Ghati means a pot. Nru mithunam. A human couple. Nru mithunam. Nru means human and mithunam means couple. Sagadam means with mace, with gada. Savinam means with lute or with veena. Chapi naro, a male with a bow. Ashva jaghano means a horse below hips. Makaro, that's crocodile. Mrugasya, that's deer or antelope. Tauli, tauli means balance. Sasasya means with crop. Dahana, with fire. Plavaga means a boat. Chakanya, kanya means a girl. So these are the meanings of first few padas. And then what does it say? Shesha, that's the remaining. Swanama sadrushaha. Swanama means their names. Sadrushaha means like. Swacharascha sarve. So they all dwell in the habitat indicated by the signs. That is what this particular stanza and their padas mean. Okay, so let's see the next part and what the commentary talks about it. The first thing, like I mentioned, the meter is Vasanta Tilaka, and in this particular video we are going to discuss about the symbols of signs, dwelling places of signs, nature of people born in various signs, how the symbols of signs were formed. Okay, so this is going to be our today's video. So what the commentary says about this? The commentary says Pisces means two fishes facing opposite directions, Aquarius a man with an empty pot on his shoulder. Please understand, it's an empty pot on his shoulder. Gemini a couple, male holding a mace or a gada and a female holding a lute or a veena. Sagittarius a male holding a bow and arrow, under waist is like a horse. So that is how Sagittarius is. Capricorn a crocodile with deer's face. Libra a man holding a balance or a cellar. Virgo a virgin girl sitting in a boat with crop in one hand and fire in another. So this is exactly how these signs are explained by the commentator or the in the commentary. That is what we are learning is Dashadhyayi. I am also referring to Rudra's commentary and Bhatotpala's commentary, but mainly I am dependent on the Dashadhyayi commentary. Now let's understand why these signs are there and what do they mean. So if you look at this particular chart that I have shown here, these signs actually refer to the birth cycle. What I mean by that is Mithuna is a couple. That couple, when they have an intercourse, after 9 months and 9 days, that is after 279 days, a baby is born. So if the sun is in Mithuna and if that time an intercourse takes place, then the baby would be born in Aries. And this is the cycle that has been explained in this particular stanza. This is one of the most important pillars about how the significations of the signs were designed or formed, how the significations of the houses were formed. So this particular diagram has little more details. Like I told, Cancer, that is Karka, and in this particular sign the conception would take place if in Mithuna the intercourse happens, and that is why the fourth house is considered as the house of a mother. And it indicates two fishes for Pisces, and the reason behind that is just before the birth, around that time, the position of the baby is heads down, because at that point in time the head is fixed in such a way that the baby would take birth in that direction. And that's why the Pisces has two fishes, and one's head is in one direction and the other fish's head is in the other direction. And similarly, all the signs, all the symbols of the signs have specific meaning in the birth cycle or during the phase of the pregnancy. Here I have given a few meaning of few signs. For example, the Virgo or Kanya, that is when the first trimester ends. Dhanu or Sagittarius, that is when the second trimester ends. And naturally, after mean sign, the baby would take the birth. So this is how all these signs are actually, the symbols of these signs are designed. And this cycle is very important if we want to understand the fundamentals of Jyotish. I have given all the details of this in my book, Untold Vedic Astrology, along with references to modern medical science. I have given, and when we look at the signs, it is little gross, or it is little summarized, because the duration of a sign is of a month. However, if you want a fortnightly development of a baby and its association with Jyotish, you may refer to my book Untold Nakshatra Jyotish. In that, I have given the development of a fetus each fortnight and its association with the nakshatra or the constellation. I have verified it with a gynecologist, and she has given me in writing that all the details that I have interpreted or mentioned in Untold Nakshatra Jyotish are medically correct. So you may feel comfortable to refer to any of those books or both the books if you want to understand one of the fundamentals, one of the pillars of Jyotish, and how the birth cycle is associated with Jyotish. Okay, let's look at further details. For example, the food indicated by all these signs. In this particular case, according to Dashadhyayi, Aries eats bitter, pungent and hot dishes. In my personal experience, Aries people also like a little more salt in the food. Taurus likes leafy vegetables. Gemini prefers dishes prepared by humans, that is food not in raw format. They want a very well prepared dish, very well decorated dish. Cancer people prefer fish or other aquatic animals or creatures, or they basically like food in liquid format more than the dry food. Leo people like meat or food that has some strong taste. For example, if a Leo person is a vegetarian, he might also like the grains, which has strong flavor. Virgo, dishes again prepared by humans, not in raw format. Even Virgo people prefer to make a lot of dishes if they are into cooking. Libra, the food in restaurants. By this, it means basically the food which is at a business place, not at home. That is what they enjoy. Scorpio. Scorpio people like, either they like very traditional dishes or they also prefer some weird food dishes which are not normal. They prefer to mix some weird components and eat them together. Sagittarius people like pungent food. They also like items like namkeen and chaat. Capricorn likes vegetables. Aquarius prefer dry dishes. And Pisces prefer liquids more than the solid food. That is how the food preferences of the 12 signs are indicated. The nature, when you speak about Aries, Aries likes traveling. They eat very fast. Their nails are little deferred, especially the nails of feet rather than the hands. They are scared of water. And they have a strong desire. If they decide to do something, then they do it at any cost. That is how Aries people are very well determined people. Taurus people are actually stronger than Aries, but they are diplomatic. They use a lot of diplomacy in their behavior. They move very slowly. Their face is wide and large. They have strong digestive fire. And they are tolerant, they can handle tough situations, and they generally don't back out even in very tough situations. That's how Taurus people are. Gemini, good at performing arts, singing, instruments, skilled in love making, good sense of humor. Gemini people learn skills very quickly. They are not very scientific, however, art or other skills they learn very quickly. That is their nature. They understand other people really well. They understand the feelings of other people very quickly. And they also have very good appetite. Cancer, crooked motion. They don't prefer to walk in a straight line. They would walk a little differently, not in a straight line. They don't like following certain rules. Even when they write, you would find that their writing is not in a straight line. Or their size of the letters is also not similar. Some of the letters would be very big, some of the letters would be relatively small. So, and if some other person looks at it, he would say, what kind of writing is this? Especially a Scorpio person person looks at the writing of a cancer person, then he would wonder, what is this person doing? Leo, the Leo person has a large face. He dislikes other gender. His fears, likes to live in caves. He might face ailments of stomach and teeth. He's very courageous and arrogant. Virgo likes lovemaking, little shy, lives in others' houses. This is, I don't know why, but this is very interesting and common that they end up living in somebody else's houses. And very sweet in communication, but very doubtful. Libra, expert in buying and selling. They are good trading people. They trade really well. They have emaciated and a wobbly body. They are wealthy. Scorpio, cruel, likes to be in gaps, likes to somehow hide somewhere. That is how their nature is. They don't prefer to face directly. They face it, but they have their own ways to face the situation. They prefer to hide. They prefer to put somebody else in the front and then face the situation. They are very sarcastic people. Sagittarius, they have royal patronage, very short limbs if they are born in the first part of Sagittarius. They look for help, they seek help from others, and they are fond of war or stories of war and so on and so forth. The second half of Sagittarius has long face, strong body, and large teeth. This is based on the commentary, that is Dashadhyay. Capricorn, lean legs, small buttocks, beautiful eyes, comfortable in lower temperatures. They enjoy lower temperatures. They in summers, they are very uncomfortable. I have experienced this myself as well. Aquarius, small face, longs for water. Many a time they are thirsty. They are, sometimes they feel like their throat is dry. They have large body, and they like to take the ownership and drive things. They are generally lucky, and they might fulfill things well. Pisces, attractive body, large head, beautiful eyes like fish. So this is the nature of Pisces based on whatever has been mentioned in Dashadhyay. There are many things which are there. The next thing that we are going to discuss is the classification of signs. So what I mean by that is quadruped signs, biped signs, crawling signs. So Aries, Taurus, Leo, later half of Sagittarius and first half of Capricorn is quadruped. Biped are Gemini, Virgo, Libra, first half of Sagittarius and Aquarius. These are biped. And crawling signs are Cancer, Scorpio, later half of Capricorn and Pisces. Then their dwelling places, the water dwelling signs are Cancer, later half of Capricorn and Pisces. City dwelling signs are Virgo, Libra, first half of Sagittarius. Village dwelling signs are Aries, Taurus, Gemini, later half of Sagittarius and Aquarius. And forest dwelling signs are Leo and first half of Capricorn. See, this first half and second half is very important because the nature of the individual changes in these cases. For example, Sagittarius first half and second half is quite different. Capricorn first half and second half is quite different. So we need to understand the signs in that manner. According to Dashadhyayi, this also indicates auspicious omens, and it also gives some rules to interpret omens. Let's look at what auspicious omens are indicated by this particular stanza. It talks about the auspicious omens. Fish, if you see a fish in water, that's an auspicious omen. If you observe a Purna Kumbha or a Kalash, that's an auspicious omen. A couple who is in very good rapport, that's an auspicious omen. A man holding a weapon, if you are going to attack someone or if you are going to file a suit or things like that, then a man holding a weapon can be considered as an auspicious omen. A woman holding an instrument, She's considered as an auspicious omen. Distinguished person holding a bow is an auspicious omen. A person on a horse, a rich trader, a good crop, a fire without smoke, and a girl approaching a native are considered as auspicious omens. Now let's look at the rules, some of the rules mentioned in Dashadhyayi about interpreting the omens. If the object is broken or smashed, then it indicates similar results of the query. So if the query is positive, then the result would be negative. If the query is negative, the result can be positive. So this actually tells us that the verbiage of the query or the question, the way it is presented, is extremely important for our analysis. The masculine objects indicate auspicious results for males, and feminine objects indicate auspicious results for females. The right part of the body is considered as masculine, and the left part of the body is considered as feminine. The cardinal directions are considered as masculine, and ordinal directions are considered as feminine. Whatever is uttered, seen, or heard at the time of query indicates the results. When we say uttered, seen, or heard, means anybody other than the querist, his actions or her actions are very important in interpreting the final outcome of the query. That is what this particular point means. In case of a query related to marriage, a spouse would be similar to a person appearing to the querist. If someone appears to the querist, then based on the looks, based on the nature, based on the type of the person appearing the querist, we can suggest, we can tell the nature of the spouse of the querist. Okay, so this is about the omens that are mentioned or indicated by Dashadhyayi for this particular stanza. Like I told you, this is one of the most important stanzas in Brihat Jatak. Very rarely people refer to these signs in this particular way, because most of us don't know the real meaning behind those. I would encourage you to understand the real meaning of the symbols of the signs and see how your analysis becomes much more precise and accurate. Like I told you, if you are interested, you may go through my books for more details. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, feel free to share. Please tell me how you feel about the videos that I'm making. It would encourage me a lot. Also press the like button so that I know that you are liking the video. And based on your feedback, I'll actually decide the path, how we can move forward and how I can present this. Thank you for watching. Have a great day. Bye.